Hi guys, sorry for the delayed review. Life was like insane. So, anyway, kind of a short review for this one. Not really a lot going on in this episode for me, sorry. Some things I did like. Gibbs's look when the victim's wife turns around and she's pregnant, he's like, oh god. They just got worse. In this episode, the Gibbs and McGee scenes were like really, really strong. They were great in theory. I like when Gibbs just goes, what do you want me to do? Needlepoint my questions? Great line, great line. Oh, and at the end, I liked like the Penelope Ducky thing going on. Tiva, McGabby tips, who needs those? It's all about the Penelope Ducky, the Pucky. I didn't really have any specific dislikes for this episode, but just some like concerns. One, Zeva says that her father was at every birthday party, or they had birthday parties together, but like his mind was still on like how to kill people. And I'm like, I thought we established that Zeva had like a daddy wasn't there complex just because of the stuff in Bait where like she was always looking in the audience for him. I don't know. It just kind of, it didn't match up with my idea for their relationship, so it kind of threw me off there. And two, they had to name the company TELUS. That was just like a personal thing. Like every time they said the name TELUS was doing this, TELUS was doing that, TELUS was making mutant worms to attack the world. Like it kind of pulled me out of the episode because my phone is through TELUS. So I'm like, that's all I can think of is like my cell phone company when I hear that word. So I'm like, what really? What's, I know it's not the same company. It just threw me off. Overall for this episode, I kind of found the case boring. I just couldn't get into it. It was just kind of there. One of my favorite things might be like the creepy guy at the end. He was like so creepy and he had this like look about him, and I don't know, I couldn't even tell what he was saying because like the audio kept cutting in and out during this episode. Damn it, Canada! Why do you do that? All I got out of him was like he had a cool look about him and he was crazy. Crazy guy. Alert. Overall, one of the better Mickey episodes, though. I'd much rather sit through this than, like, Caged, or what was the other one? The jetpack one. Oh, I hate the jetpack one. Burning hate for the jetpack one. Ugh. Don't get me started. Poor McGee, though, with the birthday card story. Like, I felt that was sad. I do like it where Penelope's like, Gibbs loves you and your daddy loves you and you just, it's gonna be okay, buddy. Like, I don't know. I liked that end where she just like was like a touching moment where like, they love you, McGee. They just don't know how to show it. It's like, oh, poor McGee. And he calls his dad and it's a happy ending. That was okay. And then there was the thing with the worms that were half robot and half worm and were gonna destroy crops. And I was like, what is this? I'm not saying that there are not things out there. There's not technology in place that might be going that way. But for a second, I was like, things just got a little sci-fi. I mean, honestly, if like, you know, for an episode that like NCIS wanted to go totally sci-fi and have like aliens and laser beams and all that stuff, I think that'd be awesome. But for some reason I was just like, robot worms, what is going on here? It was just weird for me. Wait, was it worms or caterpillars? Okay, I'm gonna be honest here, I couldn't bring myself to rewatch this episode a second time. I mean, maybe there's people out here who love this episode, but I just, like, normally I rewatch them and I was just like, I'm gonna wing it. It's not worth it. But, like, I was like, why would I just waste 45 minutes and put myself through that? It was a boring episode. I'm sorry again if you love it and you have different views. That's cool. I didn't hate it. I'm indifferent. So I'm gonna give it a 2 out of 5 because it wasn't like it was a catastrophe. I just didn't do anything for me. Sorry. But here's hoping for next week to be better. Fingers crossed. Hopefully they never have Ducky date someone whose name starts with an F, because that's just asking for trouble.